There are a lot of things in video games that tend to kind of annoy me. Maybe it's just the old man in me, get off my damn lawn. But there's a lot of narratives that are pushed by individuals, by video game websites, and by video game companies themselves about things going on in the world of video games. And inherently, I disagree with some of these narratives that are pushed, just like you do. A lot of people tend to disagree with what these bigger influencers, these bigger websites, and the game companies themselves tend to push when it comes to a narrative in the world of video games. But the latest narrative, I don't get this whatsoever. Of course, I'm talking about Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, which is the new Star Wars game coming to us from EA and Respawn. And the whole crux of this thing is, of course, the fact that EA came out and said that there's not going to be any microtransactions. There's not going to be any DLC. It is going to be a single-player Star Wars story-driven experience that people have been looking forward to. And since that announcement, there's been a lot of different things that have been happening. A lot of people are getting on their knees and worshiping the golden penis of EA, drinking from EA's golden teat in reverence of this game and acting like it's the most big thing in the world. It's the biggest announcement in forever. You know, oh my God, a single player Star Wars experience with no DLC and no microtransactions after EA has done so many Star Wars games that were just so shitty over the past few years. It's great. We're finally getting this game. And that's cool. I get that. We, of course, have only seen a CGI trailer of this game. We haven't gotten much information on the game itself, but it's definitely reason to be hyped for it. I am more of a casual Star Wars fan than a hardcore Star Wars fan. I enjoyed the original trilogy. I have played some of the games over the years. Of course, games like Knights of the Old Republic, Shadows of the Empire, Super Star Wars on the Super Nintendo. Like, I know what's going on in Star Wars. I get what's going on in Star Wars, but the more recent stuff hasn't really been that attractive to me. But I still think the universe of Star Wars is very cool. So a lot of people have very high hopes about this game. But now there's another narrative going on with Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order that once again is being pushed to us by major influencers and major websites. I see this all over Twitter with people with little check marks by their Twitter name. I guess I'm not cool enough to have a check mark by my name, but all these people are getting up on their high horse and saying things like, well, this game needs to sell well because we need to show EA that we care about single player games. And if this game doesn't sell well, then all of a sudden there will be no more single player games and it'll be sending a bad message to these companies. And that is the stupidest rhetoric when it comes to video games, because all you're doing is feeding into the false narrative. And that's what I want to talk about in this video, is the false narrative that these companies are pushing on us, that single player games don't sell well, because it's absolute bullshit when you actually look at things like game sales and when you actually look at the games themselves. And of course, when you look at the broader scope, the gaming industry and games that are based on multiplayer that also do not sell well. But I didn't want to attack this subject alone. No, no, no. When I put out a tweet that I was thinking about doing a video on this subject, my buddy Rerez from the channel Rerez and Rerez 2 reached out to me and said, hey, I have some things I want to say about this. So he's actually joining us for this video, and I'm going to let Rerez talk about some things because he actually brings up some interesting points that I wasn't even going to tackle in this video.
All these people that are online right now talking about the concept that this new Jedi Fallen Order game is so important to be successful because it's going to prove to all these other companies that single-player experiences don't need microtransactions or DLC, well, that's stupid. Everybody knows that none of these games need microtransactions or DLC or any kind of additional charges over top of buying the initial experience. In fact, they don't even need multiplayer. What they need is to be a good game. Now, while I trust the folks at Respawn to make a pretty decent game because they've made many in the past, I know that many consumers out there are a little bit worried because they think that they have this entire future responsible in their hands because they need to be the ones that are making sure that these games have some kind of life. Well, folks, guess what? It's not your responsibility. You're a consumer. All you need to do is see something and then hope it was marketed properly towards you and buy it. Whether the game is good or bad, depending on what you feel about the game, as long as it's something that you think is good and you choose to buy it, that's all that really matters. It's the company's responsibility to make things that are attractive to consumers. And guess what? Microtransactions, DLC, a whole bunch of additional features that you have to pay for on top of buying the base game? Those aren't attractive to anyone! And of course everybody knows that. But there are some people out there that have a vested interest in seeing certain games like this become successful. And for you out there, all you consumers, just be very careful and be very wise. Because in the next couple of months, with all these games coming out that are single-player experiences and the ones that have DLC, make sure to just maybe not buy DLC all that much or buy any microtransactions and watch the companies hurt a bit. And if that happens, likely we'll get a lot more better single-player experiences.
So I can definitely see what ReRes is saying. As a consumer, your main interest should be in purchasing the game itself. Purchasing the game on day one, and then that is the game that you are getting. And of course, a lot of these companies nowadays are starting to do things like season passes on day one. They're doing DLC on day one. They're doing microtransactions on day one in order to generate more money for these titles to cover costs of development of titles. That's a whole different subject for me as well, because I just feel like development costs of video games has gotten to a point of where it's almost a breaking point. And you're going to see a lot of these companies hit that breaking point. That's why a lot of companies like Activision and EA always have these horrible, horrible press releases talking about their financial situations because certain games don't sell well enough. And so I definitely understand what he's saying with this. Microtransactions and DLC are not inherently evil, but as a consumer, when you purchase the video game, you don't have to purchase those microtransactions. You don't have to purchase that DLC. If you really enjoy the game, then yeah, support the game. If you think this is a great game, you really want more content out of it, then by all means, get the DLC. Get some of the microtransactions if they tickle your fancy. But having to shoehorn in these things in order to get the full experience is just very wrong of these companies. And it really sort of hurts single-player experiences. It sort of gives single-player experiences a negative stigma, because when you hear about a game coming out that's going to be a single-player experience, now we are conditioned. We are automatically assuming that this game will have DLC, that this game will have microtransactions. So it's just absolutely ridiculous to me, and it's definitely a thing where you have to vote with your wallet when it comes to quality. But the other side of the equation is the thing that drives me absolutely mad. It drives me absolutely mad. The single player games do not sell well. According to who? That is false. F-A-L-S-E. False. Look at the best-selling games of this generation, and you can clearly see that this is a false narrative that these companies are pushing. Why are they pushing it? We'll talk about that, but let me give you guys some examples. And first and foremost, a lot of this is stemming from a tweet that an individual made with a blue check mark by his name that someone on my Twitter feed was resharing. This guy was basically saying that if it's not a Sony game or a first-party Nintendo game, it won't sell well if it's a single-player experience. And because of that, we should support Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order because it's a third-party single-player games. And for some reason, Sony and Nintendo first-party single-player games don't count in this equation, which is just stupid to me. Because when you look at the best-selling PS4 games and when you look at the best-selling Nintendo Switch games, guess what? They're single-player games. Games like Horizon Zero Dawn, games like God of War, games like Spider-Man. These are the best-selling games on the PS4. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. They are console exclusives. They are single-player experiences. So why wouldn't they count? When you look at Nintendo, Jesus Lord, Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, the best-selling Zelda game ever. Super Mario Odyssey, over 15 million copies sold. But for some reason, these games don't count because they're first-party games? Okay, well, let's talk third-party games then. You want to talk third-party games? Let's just go recently. Resident Evil 7. Resident Evil 7 sold exponentially well for Capcom. Looking at Resident Evil, Resident Evil 2 that released this year, it sold exponentially well for Capcom. You also have Sekiro that's selling very, very well for From Software. You have Red Dead Redemption 2. Well, Red Dead Redemption has online multiplayer. Yeah, and it sucks, okay? Nobody bought Red Dead Redemption 2 solely for the multiplayer aspect. They bought it to play the single-player game, much like they probably bought GTA 5 for the same thing. The multiplayer aspect did not come until much later in the game's life cycle, and it was a welcome bonus. It was a welcome feature for it, but it's not why you bought the game. So if all of these single-player games are selling, and I've just proven to you that some of the best-selling games on these platforms are single-player games, and these are the top-selling games on these platforms, why is this narrative constantly pushed? Why do companies always want to push this narrative? Simple. They want more money. Companies will get out there and bitch and moan about the rising of development costs, which has nothing to do with us as consumers. That has no bearing on whether or not I'm going to buy a game. I will buy a good multiplayer game. I will buy a good single player game. I don't care about what it costs you to make this game. I don't necessarily care about how many copies you have to sell in order to break even or in order to make a profit on this game. That has nothing to do with me. That sounds like piss poor financial management. I get it. You're trying to keep up with the Joneses. because you're trying to keep up ahead of the trends and things like that. But if you can't afford to do a huge game like this, if it's going to make or break your company, should you really be doing something like this in the first place? Is that a good business practice? Why are your shareholders and your stockholders supporting these horrible decisions where you're constantly losing money on making these big budget games because you can't afford it? There are so many indie games that have seen so much success as of late that have a fraction of the budget, yet they're making hand over fist with money because the games are good. The games are good and people like them. Games like Hollow Knight, games like Shovel Knight. There's so many indie success stories out there right now, and a lot of them, guess what? They're single player games. So to say that people do not want single player games is just ridiculous. You have, of course, catastrophes like Lawbreakers that pretty much put Cliffy B's company completely out of business because he thought there was a market for another battle royale multiplayer game where you can nickel and dime and microtransaction the hell out of people. And guess what? It didn't work. There are so many stories of failure within these games. Look at games like Battlefield 5. Battlefield 5 is a barren wasteland of a game right now. The main thing with this is it's not cut and dry. It's not single player games don't sell well. Multiplayer based and DLC based and microtransaction based games do sell well. That's stupid because data clearly refutes that. Data clearly goes against that notion. The reason these companies keep trying to press this motive and press this narrative on you is because they want to get as much money out of you as possible. DLC microtransactions are not inherently bad. There have been tons of times where DLC and microtransactions have been done very well. But unfortunately, greedy companies try to take advantage of you because of this, and they try to get as much money as they can out of you because of this. Simply say no. Simply say, I'm not interested in this additional content. I purchased the game, and this is what I want. So bringing this all back full circle, stop pushing this narrative about Star Wars Jedi the Fallen Order, saying that it needs to sell well. It needs to sell well to prove a point, because the point has been proven every console generation, including the current console generation. When the best-selling games of this console generation are games that are single-player games, shut up, because you have already proven your point, you have spoken with your wallet, and you have done what you have wanted to do. If you are interested in Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, then yes, by all means, support the game. Get the t-shirt, get the limited edition of it. That's totally cool with me. But if you're not that interested in it, and you're more like me, who will probably wait for a price drop, don't feel guilty about it. Single player games have been selling for every generation. Single player games will continue to sell for every generation, and it's a false narrative that is being pushed to you by video game companies and video game analysts, because they just want to make money on these things, let's be honest. But those are just my thoughts on the Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order situation. It's just been really eating at me ever since this was announced, and seeing all these stupid-ass people trying to make this crusade about the game, like it's the second coming of Christ and you need to support it or else you're a terrible gamer and you're ruining the gaming industry, like bullshit. Bullshit. The stats don't lie. Numbers don't lie. And the fact that you have games like Horizon Zero Dawn, God of War, Spider-Man, Uncharted 4, Resident Evil 2, Super Mario Odyssey, Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, Sekiro, Resident Evil 7, Red Dead Redemption 2, that are all single-player games, that are all fantastically selling games this generation, just proves that it is a false narrative. But let me know in the comments section down below what you think of this, and as always, guys, thank you for checking out this video. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications. I tend to yell about things from time to time, maybe that interests you. And as always, I'll catch you guys on the next video. Be sure to check out ReRez's channel too. It'll be in the description box down below. Later.